Envoy to Afghanistan Zalmay Khalilzad is scheduled to visit New Delhi and meet India's External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar today. The visit comes just 2 days after intra-Afghan talks opened in Qatar. The two men are expected to discuss India's role in the ongoing Afghan peace talks in Doha. Remember, India is a major stakeholder in the region and was also invited to the opening ceremony of the talks. Khalilzad had arrived in Islamabad on Monday, hoping to convince the Pakistani leadership to play a constructive role in the ongoing Afghan peace talks. Khalilzad met both the civilian and military leadership in Pakistan and pressed upon the establishment to not play spoiler. The deep state in Pakistan is involved in sponsoring and orchestrating terror attacks across the border. There's fear that this trend will derail the reconciliation process in Afghanistan. Meanwhile, the intra-Afghan talks were off to a rocky start as clashes broke out between the Taliban and Afghan forces nearly hours after the opening ceremony. The government accused the Taliban of attacking its convoy along a highway in Kunduz. In response, the security forces carried out airstrikes in the provinces of Baghlan and Jawzjan. The government now says that Taliban attacks have increased rather than decreased since the talks were announced. Representatives from countries including India, US, Turkey and Pakistan were also present at the opening ceremony. India's presence at the talks has not gone down well with Pakistan. Securing a ceasefire will be the civilian side's biggest goal, but Taliban is yet to agree on it. The chief negotiator, Abdullah Abdullah, has hinted that the government could release more Taliban fighters in exchange for a ceasefire. Earlier, we spoke to India's former ambassador to Afghanistan, Mr. Vivek Karju. Let's listen in to what inputs he had to share.
I think India should be raising the concern of the future structure of Afghanistan, which should be an independent structure and not be beholden to anyone. That is the point that we've made in the statement of Dr. Jaishankar, the External Affairs Minister. This, as an independent Afghanistan, is important for the entire region. And as these talks progress, clearly, they should not be influenced from outside. The fear is that because of the Taliban's connections with Pakistan, the Taliban may be influenced by the Pakistanis, and that is something that needs to be avoided, because if that takes place, then an already complex negotiation will become far more complicated. For a few reasons. The first is that the long-term stability of our region requires a peaceful and stable Afghanistan. That is an Afghanistan which will become a bridge between Central Asia and South Asia. Once Afghanistan is at peace and stability, then there will be pressure on Pakistan, added pressure, not only from Afghanistan, but from Central Asia and beyond, to open the land routes with India via the Punjab. I think that is one scenario which is realistic. The second is that a peaceful Afghanistan will also mean that the Pakistanis will not have the kind of ability that they have today to promote trouble in the region as a whole. And I think a new Afghanistan, which is that a post-intra-Afghan talks Afghanistan, should these talks be successful, and we can only hope that they are, because that will be good for all of us, will be a reality, and that Afghanistan, I'm confident, will want to see good relations with India, which is the principal power in the region.
The meeting is currently underway. For more details, let's quickly go across to our correspondent, Siddhant Sibal, who's joining us live from New Delhi at this hour. Siddhant, now that Zalmay Khalilzad's meeting is on with External Affairs Minister, what concerns can we expect from the Indian side to raise?
Well, Akanksha, yes, the meeting is underway even as we speak here in Delhi. But the main focus from the Indian side will be on Afghan soil being used for anti-India activities. This is something that India has strongly raised in the past. In fact, the Indian External Affairs Minister, when he joined the Doha ceremony, the intra-Afghan talk ceremony on Saturday, this was something that was the main focus point of the Indian External Affairs Minister. Remember, just a few months ago, we know that UN came out with a report that said that approximately 6,000 to 6,500 Pakistani associated or Pakistani nationals associated with terrorism are based in Afghanistan, especially Afpak border. This is a major concern for New Delhi. And of course, the fear is that the conversations which are going on, and if Taliban come back to Kabul in power, will Taliban again allow the territory to be used by Pakistani-based terrorists? So these are the questions which India has strongly raised with the Americans. But by and large, the fact that Zalmay Khalilzad is here in Delhi just 4 days after those talks begin shows how Washington is keen to make sure that New Delhi is also in the loop when it comes to the entire Afghan peace process. Remember, New Delhi
Siddhant, which is what brings me to my next question. Since you mentioned Khalilzad's visit and how crucial it is in the backdrop of rising American interest in South Asia and the U.S. electoral politics, how do you evaluate Khalilzad's India visit? Siddhant, can you hear me? All right, there seems to be some technical glitch at the moment. Siddhant, let me repeat my question to you. Since we're speaking about Khalilzad's visit in the backdrop of rising American interest in South Asia and the U.S. electoral politics, how do you evaluate Khalilzad's India visit?
Khalilzad's India visit, by and large, is to make sure that New Delhi is in the loop when it comes to the Afghan peace process. But yes, the American elections are coming, and the big focus by the U.S. president is withdrawal or drawdown of troops from Afghanistan. This is something that has been the top priority of the Trump administration. But by and large, it needs to make sure that its allies like New Delhi are rest assured when it comes to the issue of terrorism, that the space vacated by the Americans is not used by Pakistan-based terrorists. So by and large, that remains the key issue from New Delhi side, which of course the Washington or American side is wanting to make sure that New Delhi is assured that the territory will not be used by terrorists. But by and large, this is an important step forward when it comes to the Afghan peace process. We have seen the Indian External Affairs Minister and the Indian Defense Minister going to Tehran, and Afghanistan being a top priority. So New Delhi is also engaging with all the neighbors of Afghanistan, of course, barring Pakistan, when it comes to the Afghan peace process. And of course, Americans, who have a major stakeholdership in Afghanistan, are also reaching out to New Delhi.
Absolutely. And we shall know in some time what the outcome of this meeting was. For now, thank you so much, Siddhant Sibal, for bringing us all those latest details.